his area of workshop, Michael showed some picture from this area, and many times he showed this different side of this presentation. It was published, and today I will try to put some new vision or continuation of this study. But first, outline of our presentation was the theoretical background with focusing on three main aspects: mutation or gentrification, displacement, and gentrification in post-Soviet space. After that, we will discuss about case study, two neighboring neighborhoods, Soviet time, Sozboro, and Union Comfort Town in Kyiv, Ukraine. And concluding remarks, the main question we try to answer about confrontation or indifference. What are the social relations between two different in origin and in nowadays inhabitant social structure neighborhoods? Theoretical background. How was and since the date the emergence of so-called third world wave gentrification from approximately early 90s? But gentrification now occurs in a variety of sites and takes a myriad of forms, as Davidson and his note. Gentrification is not a singular project. The policy is different in different countries and by different social institutions of those countries. As for me, the main important signs of nowadays gentrification or mutation of gentrification is that it's a process of global process. It can be found everywhere, even in Kyiv, even in Vilnius, even in small areas, rural villages. Gentrification is a global human strategy, as Niall Smith noted. It's no longer restricted to just to Western cities. Gentrification can be found in different sites, all over the world. Other side, gentrification travel outside of the global city, so-called provincial gentrification. But gentrification does not always cascade from the urban hierarchy, from metropolitan to provincial cities. Sometimes it happens in both places at the same time. In one city, it can be at the same time in different stage of gentrification. We cannot say about gentrification is a linear process, historical. But first wave, second wave, third wave. It can be different phase in different cities. Expansion of gentrification beyond the not a traditional inner city, a traditional historical home. So called colonization of entire cities, even rural areas, decreasing to more remote regions. What about mutation or maybe maturation of gentrification? Gentrification has departed from a rose glass description and it now refers to a much broader phenomenon. It's no longer about a narrow and symbiotic quantity in the housing market. It's a bit harder. Many new terms was coined from term gentrification. First of all, urban gentrification, super gentrification, or financification, material gentrification, rural gentrification, green gentrification, studentification, and so on, so on, so on. And scholar proposed new idea of gentrification. Maybe we can do also such idea, such proposal, such a new term. New gentrification for this case is first of all outside the major city in Kyiv, mainly targets vacant land or brownfield. We discussed about new gentrification on formerly brownfield and kind of gated communities that overlap on traditional gentrification. Usually, gentrification is about displacement, but firstly, how to measure displacement exactly accuracy? As for me, it's impossible. It's and many scholars confirm this thesis that it's difficult to find people who was displaced. How to measure? Is it really displacement or no? Maybe it's not the main reason pushing them from there. But maybe other reasons they decided to change place of inhabitants. Therefore, we, in new gentrification, where vacant area who was displaced, no one. In this case, we can speak about indirect displacement. exclusion resistance, when you have some restriction to buy new flats and so on. Or phenomenology, the displacement as a loss of place rather than physical displacement. Or social cultural displacement, when the incomers take control over the area, they take all important positions in local administration and so on. We will check it at our cases. And the last theoretical aspect of education is post-social space. Many scholars from our side proposed different also terms. What processes take place there? Soft gentrification, urbanized gentrification, so-called passive gentrification, gentrification and de-urbanization that Michael talked about in the keynote speakers. And also about the idea of islands of gentrification. In 2005, Sikora also wrote that gentrifying areas in post-communist cities are small islands in a group, and so on. The same idea from Zoltán Kovács, the generation of downtown Budapest, will undoubtedly continue in the future, and the islands of gentrification will most probably expand in the future further. So we can speak maybe about some islands, some fragmented gentrification in the city. What's about our case? Sozgorod and Kotortov, Sozgorod neighborhood, or in Ukrainian socialist city, Soviet housing estate from late 50s and mostly from 60s. At the less prestigious left bank of the Dnipro, usually being divided into right part, right bank is a real key and left bank for newcomers. And therefore, Sozgorod in earlier time was also a neighborhood for newcomers. And nowadays, Comfort Town, Union area, that was started from 2010 as a local market, as a new Flemish style project, but really more densely constructed. Densely constructed buildings. We conducted 13 interviews with residents from Sozgorod and Comfort Town and added different web forums because it's you ask more naturalistic, more pure vision that where inhabitants from both sides can say a real attitude to these areas. Special characteristics of the research station. Kyiv gentrification research station differ in number of important ways from the Western European and North American case. Firstly, gentrification is not a dirty word. When we asked our respondents about everything about gentrification, what is gentrification, most of them answered, I don't know. Yeah, I know what is this. And even when we discuss with the main architect of one big Ukrainian city and ask him, what do you think about gentrification? He answered, yeah, it's a very important process, but let's discuss about us. We have many other problems, issues in our city, let's discuss this. In this case, maybe also the term gentrification is not so popular for him. So, anti-gentrification is unknown processes in our cities. Next one, tradition of little resistance to urban transformation processes, because usually our civil society know administration is decided, it will be realized. And very high share of the housing stock is owned, occupied, that reduce the risk of direct displacement. And additionally, decay of Soviet housing stock, because Khrushchev is around this new area, are mostly near the end of exploitation period. We try to understand interaction between the new build new farmers in Comfort Town and the locals living across the regeneration. Why our presentation named regeneration? Because this regeneration project was started at Regeneration Street. It's really a Regeneration Street. Why regeneration? Because of former chemical enterprises that retired, that regenerated tide, former tide. And the regeneration processes, therefore, Squid was named Regeneration. It's ironically that regeneration processes started exactly at this era. Regeneration precursor in 2008 was an unofficial decision of the administration that Khrushchevki area in Sazora will be demolished and a new 2-3 times higher buildings will be erected there. And maybe because of such promises, we found one of the walls of Khrushchevki buildings this interesting picture, Clash 4, just do it. We protest against it was really surprising, especially for my English socialist city proletarian neighborhood to see such slogan. But it was failed. No new building was built and any Khrushchevka was demolished. Is New York comfort town is an island of civilization, is hard rock, it lives in near Stockholm or beaches as a calm. Let's try. It's my favorite picture. Usually I say that it's not Photoshop, it's not my painting, not Michael's painting, maybe our boss. But really, it's from plain, nice picture when surrounded by gray neighborhood from Soviet time, but more green area in compare with comfort town. And we can see this line or interface between two different neighborhoods, picturesque or colorful comfort town and the gray, sad comfort town. Attitudes toward comfort town. One side, overall, it's a complex for young and successful people with a positive attitude towards life. And the other side, this area, in my opinion, it's a depressing corner surrounded by all Khrushchevkis, railway garages, and so on. Well, really, the picture you see is a boulevard, Dacia's boulevard, but really a high power line where local people are working with the jobs. Is it an island of civilization? Usually, comfort town emphasizes as an island of civilization on the left bank of the Dnieper, so sort of a pretty hoody place. But at the same time, after first 1 or 2 years, it was king. Why? Because local people who go inside to this area to walk, to bring something, and to destroy some monuments. It's a very interesting monument, deer with the horns. And the local people every time from Sosvora come into this area and destroy horns. In Russian we have a term, Ablamai Praha, and they try to destroy these horns for symbol of bourgeois, new crowds. And that was the fence. But we checked, is the fence really as a rule for outsiders? If you come to garden and ask, may I come? No, it's impossible. But Michael's idea, let's buy some boxes with foodstuffs and try to come. When you go to the door, garden open. Door is coming. After that, you can walk there without any problem. I see that my time is over. Briefly, other aspect of the comfort town, very interesting. One way openness. When we ask the comfort town citizens where the children visit the school because they have US school, they say, no, we don't use the school because of its high prices for more wealthy people. And we go to this socialist time school. But who is this? A wealthy man from outside of this area, from right bank, they visit this school. And in this case, it's one way openness. Other, is it a physical effect? No, minus. Physical effect? Yeah. Physical effect of physical influence of comfort town on surrounding area. Two aspects, cooling and insulting. Cooling or with air conditioner. Uses a comfort tower and surrounded without any more effective metro station in this area. The same situation in the insulation as a sign of housing modernization. Also near metro station, but no effect surrounded by comfort tower. But you can find just one building that was modernized in this area. It was a very surprise for me to find such a building, former Khrushchev, with new balcony, with new facade, as an eco hotel in the South Gora. But it was nowadays it closed. Why? Because it was projected before Euro 2012 for cheaper housing for football fans. And after that, it was closed, this project. Just one building was modernized, but not because of comfort town, because of football. And at the same time, in this area, we can find so-called other kind of islands of communal apartments in Khrushchevki, in front of comfort town area. This heat map shows some areas of high concentration of communal apartments in Khrushchevki, double boosted people. New processes that we can see replicas from island to archipelago of civilization. For example, at Nivki area, also we can see the same town, Faina town, Faina, a nice game of words, Faina town is the same project surrounded by Khrushchev. The same situation in other, both at the right wing, Respublika residential complex is the same picturesque building. Interestingly, we conducted some interview before this new replicas was organized, and most of people we asked, what do you think if new residential complexes will be constructed in this area? Most of them say, no, we have enough buildings in this area, we protest. But after 2 years, it was the new area. Concluding remarks. So, Khrushchev town is an island of civilization in CADLA, the biggest island in the Kyiv neighborhood, archipelago, a unique case in a unique strength. Little contact or self understanding between locals and newcomers, an island with hard rocky cliffs rather than beaches, and little textural effect on the surrounding environment. Khrushchev town largely ignores surroundings, has its own stores, pharmacy, and so on. And is an archipelago of indifference rather than confrontation, and fragmentation rather than cohesion. And last idea, we used a metaphoric term rainbow fields, and maybe we can call it new term rainbowification. In case of you, maybe it will be also new process. I said before, your attention, and sorry for